Hello, vinyl community. Hope everybody's doing well. And I hope everybody's ready for another round of pickups. Not too many this week, but some pretty cool stuff. So let's get started. I found this on Amazon, The Sons of Adam. Saturday Sons. The complete recordings 1964 to 1966. Now, this is a two album set. The first disc has the Sons playing at the Avalon Ballroom in 66. Side two has what I believe is the Sons of Adam's singles, or I don't think they had an album. This is sort of a blind buy because I haven't heard most of this. The second disc has outtakes on the first side. On the second side, they have material from the band Fender Four, which I guess was the band that morphed into the Sons of Adam. So yeah, it's not only did we have extensive liner notes in the inner cover.
Penis.
Looks like we've got some singles there. We've also got a very cool, first let me show you the hype sticker. I'm gonna do a thumbnail of that hype sticker, so it'll be up there. We've got a very cool booklet. This has got a lot of cool information on it. We've got the
Patty Liver.
Am I doing this again? I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts.
Chewing in an ass over the pressure.
Interviews, it looks like we've got. Very cool. We've got two photos of a concert poster and the band live. I guess that's 66. I'll know a lot more about this band after I read this. One thing we know is the guitar player, yeah, Randy Holden, he was he is a psychedelic guitar legend. He's been in like at least six psychedelic garage bands in the 60s. So yeah, that's one thing. I've not heard this yet. I'm looking forward to it. And on the other side of this video, I'll let you know how it is. That's the vinyl, black vinyl, both discs. So yeah, Sons of Adam. Looking forward, looks like we've got Surf, Garage, and Psych all in this two-disc set, so looking forward to it. I hit an estate sale Friday. And found a couple of gems. First one we got is Friends from the Beach Boys. Year this came out. Still in the shrink. They were $5 a piece, these albums. This is pretty good. I like this. We've got some instrumental type things with vocal harmonies that are really nice. And we've got Mike Love has got a couple of like meditation type songs on here also. I think this is around the time that he may have went to India with the Beatles. But yeah, this is pretty cool. Next one we've got is also cool. Face to Face by the Kinks, featuring Sunny Afternoon. They had to do that. They had to put the single on the album cover. Either that, or they didn't put the single on the album, and they just released it as a single, so. Great album. On the
Mound of Ukrainian People.
Reprise. Yeah, Reprise. Mono. Very cool to have it on mono. And yeah, I actually read this book, but it's great. Very extensive book. What? Now, two guitar players from Baltimore packed it up and headed to California to form a rock band, and they started a surf band. They got a rhythm section. They started a surf band called Defender 4. And they kind of had a regional, they were a regional band, basically. But the thing is, the region was California, which is very cool. And they kept pretty busy. They had a fan club, and they were doing okay. And they even hooked up with Kim Foley, who took over as kind of a manager type thing. And first thing he did was suggest they change their names. And not only did he suggest they change their names, but he even had a name already picked out for them called the Sons of Adam. They were down with it. They changed the name, and they went on and for about another year, and the usual stuff happened. They got sick of each other, and they never really broke out of the West Coast, really. And they got flack from club owners because they were very loud. They were the house band at Grizzardi's. I think I probably pronounced that wrong, but it's a California club back in the 60s, all the way up until the 80s, I believe. But a lot of the smaller clubs they played, the owners would complain about the noise, and it caused not only friction between Randy Holden and the club owners, but Randy and the band. Because the band were all tripping on acid, and they wanted to play, kind of folk, psych, hippie stuff. And Randy Holden wanted to play loud R&B, psychedelic stuff. So, it started to come apart for him. The drummer went on to joined the band Love. He was friends with Arthur Lee, and Arthur Lee
was looking for a drummer, and but he wouldn't go, and finally the band was in a break, so he said, yeah, I'm going to join Love. And Holden went on to join a band called The Other Half, which is another kind of short-lived band, and he went on to play with Blue Cheer on one side of New and Improved. And he was even supposed to do a trio with one of the guys from Blue Cheer, but he went on to make a great album called Population 2, a two-man band, and that's a kind of a classic. I need to get that one, but yeah, it's a great album. I don't know what my favorite side is. Probably the this side, what we're listening to right now, the Fender 4, the surf music side. But it's all good. The first two sides are at the Avalon Ballroom. And yeah, it's a very nice, nice set. So yeah, that's it. That's last week's pickups. And I'll see you again. I think we got Record Store Day coming up. But take care, all.
When I went through what's called a fatty liver.